To her master, nay father, to her husband, nay brother, his handmaid, nay daughter, his spouse, nay sister, to Abelard, Eloise. Your letter, written to a friend for his comfort, beloved, was lately brought to me by chance. Seeing at once from the title that it was yours, I began the more ardently to read it in that the writer was so dear to me that I might at least be refreshed by his words as by a picture of him whose presence I have lost. These things I deem that no one can read or hear with dry eyes, for they renewed in fuller measure my griefs. So diligently did they express each several part, and increased them the more in that thou relatedst that thy perils are still growing, so that we are all alike, and throbbing bosoms await the latest rumor of thy death. And so, in his name, who still protects thee in a certain measure for himself, in the name of Christ, as his handmaids and thine, we beseech thee to deign to inform us by frequent letters of those shipwrecks in which thou art still tossed, that thou mayest have us at least, who alone have remained to thee, as partners of thy grief or joy. And to say nothing of the rest, think by what a debt thou art bound to me, but what thou owest to the community of devoted women, thou mayest pay more devotedly to her who is thine alone. Thou knowest, dearest, all men know what I have lost in thee, and in how wretched a case that supreme and notorious betrayal took me myself also from me with thee, and that my grief is immeasurably greater from the manner in which I lost thee than from the loss of thee. And strange it is to relate, to such madness did my love turn, that what alone it sought, it cast from itself without hope of recovery, when, straightway obeying thy command, I changed both my habit and my heart, that I might show thee to be the one possessor both of my body and of my mind. Who among kings or philosophers could equal thee in fame? What kingdom or city or village did not burn to see thee? Who, I ask, did not hasten to gaze upon thee when thou appearedst in public, nor on thy departure with straining neck and fixed eye follow thee? What wife, what maiden did not yearn for thee in thine absence, nor burn in thy presence? What queen or powerful lady did not envy me my joys and my bed? There were two things, I confess, in thee especially, wherewith thou couldst at once captivate the heart of any woman. Namely, the art of making songs and of singing them, which we know that other philosophers have seldom followed, wherewith, as with a game, refreshing the labor of philosophic exercise, thou hast left many songs composed in amatory measure or rhythm, which, for the suavity both of words and of tune being oft repeated, have kept thy name without ceasing on the lips of all, since even illiterates the sweetness of thy melodies did not allow to forget thee. It was on this account, chiefly, that women sighed for love of thee. And as the greater part of thy songs descanted of our love, they spread my fame in a short time through many lands and inflamed the jealousy of many women against me. For what excellence of mind or body did not adorn thy youth? What woman who envied me then does not my calamity now compel to pity one deprived of such delight? What man or woman, albeit an enemy at first, is not now softened by the compassion due to me? Give thy attention, I beseech thee, to what I demand, and thou wilt see this to be a small matter and most easy for thee. While I am cheated of thy presence, at least by written words, whereof thou hast an abundance, present to me the sweetness of thine image. Remember, I beseech thee, what I have done, and pay heed to what thou owest me. I have forbidden myself all pleasures that I might obey thy will. I have reserved nothing for myself save this, to be now entirely thine. Consider, therefore, how great is thine injustice, if to me who deserve more thou payest less, nay, nothing at all, especially when it is a small thing that is demanded of thee, and right easy for thee to perform. When in time past thou soughtest me out for temporal pleasures, thou visitedst me with endless letters, and by frequent songs didst set thy Eloise on the lips of all men. With me every public place, each house resounded. How more rightly shouldst thou excite me now towards God, whom thou excitest then to desire. Consider, I beseech thee, what thou owest me. Pay heed to what I demand. And my long letter, with a brief ending, I conclude. Farewell. My all.